silent a few minutes. Well, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. I guess it's all three time of the day covered. How's everyone doing? We're good? We're good? Well, it's a privilege that my name is Ting. This lovely lady here is Grace on the keyboard. And a privilege to be able to lead worship with all of you and just worship God together this evening. I would like you all to stand in your room. As we just quieten our hearts as we come before the Lord in worship. I want to just quickly read Psalm 95. And I think it pertains to the first song we're going to start. So Psalm 95 says, "Come, let us sing for joy to the Lord. Let us shout aloud to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before him with thanksgiving and extol him with music and song. For the Lord is a great God, the great King above all gods. In his hand are the depths of the earth, and the mountain peaks belong to them. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands formed the dry land. Come, let us bow down and worship. Let us kneel before the Lord our Maker, for he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture, the flock under his care." So we're going to sing all that this evening. So will you join us as we worship?
You are to worship. Thank you.
And I just feel really what a privilege to be able to see you for the first time. I think most of you, it's the first time I've seen you in the Doctor of Ministry program. And it's a, I have to say to you, it's a privilege. So a little background, the Union Grace was also the end of the program, and when Bridget approached us, I was like, it's going to be so amazing to meet all these great minds. I feel like my words are definitely very limited in this room. But the one thing I know that is true is no matter where we have come from, no matter how far we have come in our studies, in our journey with God, our goal as one Gordon-Conwell, our goal as one community is to glorify the name in everywhere we go and everywhere we see. And that's what we're here tonight, and I believe that what God has given us to you is going to be true, and what He has given us to you is going to be the next step as we take in this next few hours in this coming weekend. So I invite you, as we come before Him this evening, as we sing, as the deer panted for the water, that even though we are all filled with the knowledge of the Bible and filled with the knowledge of theology, we still need God. Not all of us are perfect here. Not all of us are here saying that we have everything under control, that we have everything put together. Instead, even as followers of Jesus, we have fallen short. We can fall short. But we're here together to build each other up. And most importantly, to know that Jesus is here with us. He built us up from the bottom. Amen.
Thank you. Joy to the We just declare the words, Lord, here we are to save this hymn of love before you. And we want to intentionally remind ourselves the faithfulness you have shown in my life, in my community's life, in my family's life, in my nation. Lord, we just want to come as a collective, as one corporate body, to remember your faithfulness, to remember your goodness over our lives. Can you just see our Lord Savior just as his arms have been stretched wide on the cross, the blood that was shed for the forgiveness of our sins, those very arms are just holding us close right now. Those arms are the everlasting arms that promise to never let us go. Those are the arms that are holding you high, holding your arms high when you feel like you have no strength. Every season, whether it's in the mountaintops or the valley lows, in the bitterness, in the anguish, in the grief, or even the joys of life, in the celebration of life, or the grieving of death, through all the seasons, these are the arms that will never hold you, never let you go. They will hold you forever and ever. And even right now, in a moment in time, as the doctor ministry, all these people come together, he is holding us tight even right now. Even in the midst of COVID, all of you here have safely arrived here in Gordon-Conwell. And even we had a recent fire here in this building, and still we can gather here in Kaiser Chapel to worship, and nothing can hinder the worship of our King. So right now, we may be physically apart, and even those who are joining with Zoom, but he is holding us all together. He is unifying us. Even in the next few days, as we talk about different topics, as we talk about race, as we talk about the matters that are dividing the church, he is the one who is holding us close. He is the one who will unify us. So we come. What better response can we give but to give him our worship? So just allow his love to flow in his place. Allow yourself to be in the posture to receive. He is ready to pour out. Are you ready to receive? So we come. Lord Jesus, we come. And together we say, Lord Jesus, you're welcome here. Come, Lord Jesus.
Oh, let your love surround.
weary and tired, but our God will never faint. He will never tire out. He is the one who never slumbers and watches over you day and night. He is the God who sees. He is Jehovah Elroy, the God who sees all that you are going through, all the pain, all the burdens. He knows that your labor that is done for him is not in vain. And he promises those who wait on the Lord shall renew their strength like eagles. And that as a generation, we can be the generation that can continue to run. We can continue to run the race with perseverance. We can run the race that is marked for us. There is a high calling. There is a prize marked for us with our name on it. But we are not called to run with our own strength. We are called to be empowered in the Holy Spirit, that the same power that conquered the grave also lives in each and every one of us and dwells among us. And so we can run the race. We can fix our eyes on Jesus. Let us fix our eyes on Jesus. Throw off everything, all the sin that entangles us, all the temptations. We cast it all aside, but we fix our eyes on Jesus. We are called to seek his face and seek his kingdom and his righteousness. Oh God, we ask, would you fix our eyes upon you once again? Lord, that it is so easy to get so stuck with all the chatter here and there. It's so easy to get caught up with what the culture is saying. It's so easy to caught up with everything, all the different distractions, all the different voices. But God, may we be still and heed to the voice of the shepherd. For the sheep knows the shepherd's voice. And the shepherd is calling all of us by name. So God, we ask for the next few days, next few hours, the time that you have given us as a community, may we not take this time for granted. We pray for divine conversations, divine connections. We pray for divine inspiration and creativity and revelation of wisdom, O God. That we will not budge a step forward without your guidance, without your counsel. We will not turn to the left, we will not turn to the right, but we will only stay on the path of righteousness. Lead us, God. We give you permission to lead us and guide us. So thank you, Lord, for the assurance and the promise that you are holding us so close, that we may stumble and fall, but you are the God who strengthens our feeble knees. Thank you, God, that we are never alone, that you are God Emmanuel, God with us. So we commit all of our conversations, all of our brainstorming, all of our execution, all of our plans before you, God. May the purpose of the Lord prevail tonight. And we pray this in the most beautiful, mighty, and beautiful, mighty, and honorable name of Jesus Christ, our Savior. All God's people say.
Skills for ministry as they launch out into the world. That's fire for your ministry, and also oxygen for your souls to be renewed, to be refreshed, to remember your call to fall in love with Jesus.